دوما قريب. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام عليك يا صفوة الأنبياء والمرسلين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أيام معدودات، فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين، فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له، وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه، ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر، ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب، أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعاني، فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. صدق الله العظيم، وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم، وقال حبيبه المصطفى المجتبى صلى الله عليه وسلم: من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. وقد صدقت أنت يا سيدي يا سيدي يا سيدي، يا مكي يا مدني يا عربي يا قرشي يا هاشم، ويا سيدنا يا سيدنا يا سيدنا، يا حبيبنا يا طبيبنا، يا حبيب المصطفى المجتبى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. In these Quranic verses, Allah Jalla wa Ala has commanded us, has ordered the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam to observe Sawm. The hukm of fasting was given to the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. The ahkam of Ramadan and the ahkam of fasting are only found in the Quran, in one part of Quran. And that is in Surah Al-Baqarah. It is only these Quranic verses. So if you want to study the ahkam of fasting, the laws of fasting, the rulings of fasting, the wisdoms of fasting, the usul of fasting, the fiqh of fasting, everything is in these Quranic verses. These verses of the Quran that I've just recited in Surah Al-Baqarah. And this begins with verse 183. To verse 187. All Ramadan and ahkam of fasting are from 183 to 187. Everything about fasting is in these Quranic verses. So if you want to study the ahkam of fasting in Al-Quran, it is in Surah Al-Baqarah from verse 183 to verse 187. Inshallah, we'll be discussing the shan and nuzul of these Quranic verses also, and why Allah Jalla wa Ala selected Surah Al-Baqarah for the ahkam of Ramadan. Inshallah, we'll be discussing that in detail. First thing that I will begin with is the hukm, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, O believers, kutiba alaykum as-siyam, fasting has been prescribed upon you, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, the way it was made an obligatory upon those who were before you. And then Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions the maqsad of fasting, the goal of fasting. Why is it that we fast? Why do we keep roza? Why do we observe fasting? What is the maqsad of it? What is the goal of it? Is it about remaining thirsty, hungry, controlling your desires, not to have a relationship, an intimate relationship with your spouse? Is it all about that? Allah Jalla wa'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The maqsad of fasting is taqwa. Is to attain taqwa. The word taqwa comes from al-wikaya, and al-wikaya means protection, to protect yourself. It is a state of consciousness, awareness of Allah Jalla wa Ala, to fear Allah Jalla wa Ala, to have the khawf of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And when you fear Allah Jalla wa Ala, and when you have true love of Allah Jalla wa Ala, you will protect yourself from everything that displeases Allah Jalla wa Ala. And it is interesting that even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, when he refers to as-sawm, he says, as-siyamu junnatun. Fasting is a shield. As-siyamu junnatun. Fasting is a shield, and shield is used for protection, to protect yourself. And here in the Quran, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامُ كَمَا قُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That fasting has been prescribed upon you the way it was prescribed upon those who were before you. And who are before us? Who has come before us? It is the Bani Israel. In Surah Baqarah, Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions Bani Israel. Before this verse 183, Allah Jalla wa Ala repeatedly reminds the Yahud about their lack of taqwa, that they did not have taqwa. Allah constantly mentions that. Ya Bani Israel, O Bani Israel. Remember, they observed fasting. They kept roses. Even the Yahud, the Nasara, the Hunud, before fasting became fard upon the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the month of Ramadan, the fasting of Ayyamul Bid was fard. Ayyamul Bid are the 13th, 14th and 15th of every month, the 10th of Muharram. Now the ahkam are changing. The hukum is changing now. Allah Jalla wa Ala is addressing the Yahud that the purpose that Yahud were given a hukum, and that was a fasting. And the purpose of their fasting was also taqwa. It was to attain taqwa. Consciousness of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Awareness of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Fear of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Which the Sufiya, they translate the khawf of Allah Jalla wa Ala as the true love of Allah Jalla wa Ala. When you love someone, then you fear displeasing your beloved. That is also khawf, and that's taqwa. So Allah Jalla wa Ala repeatedly mentions, O Yahud, O Bani Israel, fasting was made fard upon you. But you did not have taqwa. You did not have taqwa. You did not have taqwa. And then when Allah Jalla wa Ala gives a hukm to the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions the same thing, that the previous nations, the hukum for them was to observe roza, to observe sawm. And the maqsad of their sawm was also taqwa. And then Allah Jalla wa Ala says, O believers, now fasting has been made fard upon you, the way it was made fard upon those before you. And the maqsad of fasting for you, it is the same as the previous nations. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you attain taqwa. It is the same. There is no difference. So do not make the same mistake as the Bani Israel. Do not make the same mistake. The mistake that they made. What was their mistake? They used to fast. Even though it was different. It was for 3 days and 1 day. And then there are many other different ahkam. Because they would do iftar. And after iftar, if they were to fall asleep, then after that there was no suhoor. They would remain hungry till the next day's iftar time. And this was another confusion in the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the next verses of the Quran in which it is clarified. Now, with the Yahud, the issue with them was that when they heard that the hukum for the Muslim has come from Allah Jalla wa Ala, and just before this, just before the hukum of fasting, Allah Jalla wa Ala gives the hukum of the changing of Qibla. The changing of Qibla. Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ كِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. Now, these new ahkam were given. Now there's a sudden change, a big change. Why is Yarfaw Ibrahim al-Qawaida? Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he is the one who built the Kaaba. And Yahud had this superiority complex. They thought that they were better than every other nation. They had this, they believed that they are better. We are superior, we are better than everyone else. We are the chosen ones. So Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam here. He mentions the importance of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Why does he mention Ibrahim alayhi salam? We know that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, his son's name is Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. And he has another son whose name is Sayyidina Ishaq alayhi salam. And Yahud are from the lineage of Sayyidina Ishaq alayhi salam. They are the Israelites. We are the Ishmaelites. We are from Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. And Yahud, they claim that since we are the chosen ones, and if a prophet comes, then he has to come from Sayyidina Ishaq alayhi salam. As long as he is from our ancestors. So Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam here. Ibrahim alayhi salam is the one who built the Kaaba. Meaning, O Yahud, what is the difference? The root is the same. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam is the father of Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is from the lineage of Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam, he is also from Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. So what is the difference? So if you believe that you are special only because of your lineage, then look at the roots. The root is Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam here. And he mentions the building of Kaabatullah, that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam is the one who actually built Kaabatullah. Now remember, as I said, that they felt superior. Remember in Makkah al-Mukarramah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he would pray his salah, the hukum was to face in the direction of Masjid al-Aqsa. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to pray in the direction of Kaabatullah, but he used to stand in a position where he could face Kaabatullah and Masjid al-Aqsa simultaneously. That was possible in Makkah al-Mukarramah. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Madinah al-Munawwarah, it was impossible. Because if you were facing in the direction of Masjid al-Aqsa, you would have to have your back towards Kaabatullah. And this is why Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned, once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Madinah al-Munawwarah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was establishing his prayer. And then Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions this, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ كِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. Oh beloved, I can see you constantly raising your head up. I know this is what you desire. I know this is what you want. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ كِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. This is the hukum. That we have changed the Qibla. Which, to which direction? The direction that pleases you. For your pleasure, O beloved. For your pleasure. This is for the pleasure of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now Yahud didn't like this. They were upset. Because a new nation has been introduced, a new qawm has been introduced, and they understood that Muslims, their following was increasing. The message of Islam was spreading everywhere. But the greatest problem that the Yahud had, they knew that even though they have come with a new Sharia, with a new prophet, a new messenger, but as long as the direction of the Qibla, it is the same as our Qibla. They pray in the same direction and we pray in the same direction. The direction has changed, and this is something that really hurt the Jews. They didn't like this. يَعْرِفُونَ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ. They actually knew the Prophet the way they knew their children. They recognized everything about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They read about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They knew the signs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's just their arrogance. It is just their takabbur. They couldn't take it from Ishmaelites, from the family of Sayyidina Ismail alaihi wasallam. How is that possible? So the messengership has now been shifted. It is coming from Sayyidina Ismail alaihi wasallam. First thing is the Qibla has changed. Now after the changing of the Qibla, there was another thing that the Muslims shared with the Yahud, and that was fasting. 13th, 14th, 15th of every month. And then the hukum of fasting on Ashura and the 10th of Muharram was the same. Now after the changing of Qibla has changed. Verse 183, 84, 185, 186, 187, all of this is about Ramadan. And before that, Allah Jalla wa'ala is constantly reminding the Yahud, oh Yahud, you did not have taqwa. All these ahkam were given, but these are the mistakes that you made. And then after that, Allah Jalla wa'ala changes the Qibla. After the Qibla changes, then Allah Jalla wa'ala gives the hukum of sawm, of fasting. And after the hukum of fasting, Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. This is the month in which Al-Quran was revealed. Al-Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. It is the month in which Al-Quran was revealed. And then after these verses of the Quran, Al-Hajj ashurun ma'lumat, فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجَّ فَلَا رَفَصَ أَحْكَامَ الْحَجِّ. And we know that they performed Hajj, they had their own method, their own ways of performing Hajj. They had changed the asr of the Sharia of Islam, but they had their own way of performing Hajj. Now the clear ahkam of Hajj were also revealed. So here Allah Jalla wa'ala, he mentions, first he reminds the Yahud that these are the things in which you could not observe taqwa. Now, O believers, O Muslims, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. fasting has been made for the Panya. Now remember, there are some scholars nowadays who actually claim, and they are very adamant in their claim to say that these verses of the Quran are not for the month of Ramadan. Ya ayyuha allatheena amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba alal ladheena min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. صلى الله على محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. محترم احبا، ان شاء الله تعالی اس خصوصی ٹرانسمیشن میں ہم ہر لیکچر کے بعد ایک خاص ورد تحفتاً اپنے ناظرین اور حاضرین مجلس کو دیا کریں گے. تو آج کا تحفہ، آج کا خصوصی ورد، ان شاء اللہ تعالی آپ اس کو نوٹ کر لیجئے. یہ خاص ورد سٹوڈنٹس کے لیے ہے. سٹوڈنٹس اکثر کہا کرتے ہیں کہ ہمیں ایگزامز کے لیے تیاری کرنے میں دشواری ہوتی ہے، اور جو ہم ریوائز کرتے ہیں وہ اس کو میمورائز کرنا، اس کو ریٹریو کرنا، اس انفارمیشن کو یاد کرنا ہمارے لیے مشکل ہو جاتا ہے. تو اسٹوڈنٹس کے لیے خاص وظیفہ ہے کہ کمرہ امتحان میں جانے سے قبل حالت وضو میں قصیدہ بردہ شریف کا یہ ایک شعر ہے، اس کو آپ انشاءاللہ تعالی زبانی یاد کر لیں. اور حالت وضو میں یہ شعر آپ نے 11 مرتبہ پڑھنا ہے، اول آخر درود شریف. یہ شعر آپ لکھ لیجئے. فَإِنَّ مِن جُودِكَ الدُّنْيَا وَضَرَّتَهَا وَمِنْ عُلُومِكَ عِلْمُ اللَّوْحِ وَالْقَلَمِ. Special litany that will be given to all the brothers and sisters. Inshallah, if you can take notes. It is for the students. Before you enter the exam room, inshallah, if you recite this 11 times and durood upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam before and after it, inshallah, this will help you to retrieve the information, all the revision that you have done. You'll be able to recall it and remember it in the exam room, inshallah. It is something that is very useful for students. So if you can take note, you read it 11 times before you enter the exam room in the state of wudu, and before and after it you recite durood upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Fa inna min judika ad-dunya wa darrataha wa min ulumika al-lawhi wal qalami. So inshallah, this is a khas word, a special gift for all students. Before you enter the exam room, you recite this, inshallah, this will be useful for you, and it will be a blessing for everyone for success in the exams, inshallah, to pass the exams. Jazakumullahu khayra wa ahsanul jazaa.